So, Gmod FNAF Pill Pack review videos are back! Ha ha ha! Well, they always come back! Ha 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 ha! Just how I like them! Ha ha!
Alright! Hey guys, welcome back to another Gmod Five Nights at Freddy's review video! And today, we're going to be checking out a brand new pill pack. Well, a pill pack that is brand new to me. So this pill pack has been out for a few months, but I'm finally checking it out. So today, we're going to be checking out the Geo's Junkyard pill pack. So this is a pill pack made by Geo, and currently in this pack there are four different animatronics. Now if you guys do want to check out this pill pack for yourself, it will be linked in the description below. But anyways, without further ado, let's go ahead and dive straight into it. So in this pack you can choose between Burn Trap, Innard, Nightmare Freddy, and the Mimic. So first of all, we are going to start off with our boy Burn Trap. Burn Trap, get out here, buddy. Come on, it's time for the review, Burn Trap. It's time for the review. Come on out. Blah, blah, blah. Stop with all that yapping. I got a special announcement to make. Greetings, my name is Freddy Fazbear, a member of the Fazbear Band. Yes, that's right, the Fazbear Band. The Fazbear Band is a brand new YouTube channel that I have created with my friends to document all of our epic, crazy, weird, strange adventures for you guys to enjoy. So it would mean the absolute world if you guys would consider becoming a part of the band by checking out our YouTube channel, the Fazbear Band. Wait, what the heck? What is this thing doing here? There's a plant pot right here. What should I do with it? Oh, whoopsies. Oh, I gotta go!
Do I have to? I don't want to go outside!
Come on, Burn Trap, everyone wants to know more about you!
Fine. The outside world. I don't really spend that much time outside. The bright blue sky. Honestly, I kind of forgot that the sky was blue. I'm going to be completely honest. The outside world. The white fluffy clouds. The green grass. I guess life ain't so bad after all. Well, time to go back inside where there's air conditioning.
Hey, Burn Trap, get back here!
Fine. I guess I'll come back, because I always come back.
Anyways, let's go ahead and check out Burn Trap. So, first of all, right off the bat with Burn Trap, whenever you decide to morph into Burn Trap, you have a chance of spawning in as one of two different skins of Burn Trap. So, the first skin that you can spawn in as Burn Trap is the skin where Burn Trap has no eye glow effect. So, this is basically what I like to call the deactivated version of Burn Trap. So Burn Trap right here has no life in his eyes, but then the other skin of Burn Trap has that purple eye glow effect. So personally, I like the version of Burn Trap with his purple eye glow effect, but if you wanted to have a version of Burn Trap where he's deactivated, you can easily morph to the other skin. So anyways, let's go ahead and dive into all the unique parts about Burn Trap. So first of all, we have Burn Trap's ideal animation. This is where Burn Trap, you know, he's just vibing, he's just chilling, you know, he's like,
oh yes, yep, just chilling on the side of the sidewalk, yep. That's what I'm doing. nobody likes me.
Anyways, with Burn Trap, we have his regular walk-in animation. So this is Burn Trap, you know, just going for a nice little stroll.
Oh yes, I love to spend my spare time going for walks in the park. Could never go wrong with a nice old walk.
Anyways, with Burn Trap, if you crouch as him, he will do this animation where he holds out his hand. It looks like Burn Trap is trying to use the force.
Oh, the force? What is the force?
Use the force, Burn Trap. Use the force. Trust me.
Very well then. I will use the force. Ah! Bon, da-na-na, da-na-na. Shoot, I'm not very good at this.
Well, Burn Trap, it looks like you're a Jedi.
Who said I was a Jedi? Wait, what the heck? How are you still alive?
Because I always come back.
What? Hey, you stole my line! You know what I have to say to that? Yes, I greatly appreciate that.
So with Burn Trap, if you use your secondary attack, Burn Trap will do this laugh animation. Yeah, this guy is definitely a psychopath. Anyways, with Burn Trap, we also have his run animation right here. So you have him walking and then he starts running. Whenever he runs, he does have his arm out as he is trying to grab whatever it is that he is chasing.
Get back here, invisible person! Get back here! I'm going to get you!
Burn Trap, what are you doing?
What? Oh, I'm just playing tag with my imaginary friend. Yep. I am going insane. I spent 30 years alone in a safe room, so me and my pal, we've been keeping things alive. Isn't that right, buddy? Where'd he go? I thought he was here. Where'd he go? Oh, well.
All right, and the last animation to check out is Burn Trap's jump scare animation. So this right here is a Burn Trap. So whenever you attack as Burn Trap, he will do his little jump scare animation. So there you go, there's all the main animations to Burn Trap. Also, something else, if you did not notice, is that with this pill pack, this is one of those special pill packs where wherever you're looking, the pill pack head will follow. So Burn Trap.
Oh yes, what is it?
It says gullible on the ceiling.
What? It does? Oh, wait a minute. Haha, you're so funny. We're outside. There is no ceiling. Wait, what did you say I was?
Anyways, Burn Trap. So there you go. You can move your head all around and look from side to side. So I really like that effect on these pill packs. I just think it makes the pill packs feel a lot more realistic. Wherever you're looking, the pill pack will follow. So all that's really left to go over Burn Trap is all of the different sounds that he can make. So first of all, if you press the space bar, he will make a metal electric hit sound effect right there. And if we press the reload button, it will play Burn Trap's hacking sound effect. So whenever Burn Trap is trying to hack somebody in Five Nights at Freddy's 6, whenever he's trying to hack Glamrock Freddy. And also this sound will keep on going until you press the reload button again. All right, so next that we have is Innard. So right here is Innard's ideal animation, whenever Innard is just chilling. We then have Innard's walk animation. So Innard is just going through the private room. Oh, I'm gonna get that guard. I'm gonna get that guard if it's the last thing I do. So anyways, with Innard, we also have Innard's crouch animation. So whenever Innard crouches, he will lean over and open up his faceplate. And also the cool thing with Innard, unlike Burn Trap, is while you are crouching, you can actually crouch walk. So this is something that you can't do with Burn Trap, but you can do it with Innard. So with Innard, if you want him to walk around with his faceplates open, you can easily do that, but he is still pretty slow. So I believe he's slightly faster whenever you walk normally, but whenever he crouch walks, he is going to be a bit slower, which honestly, I guess that makes some sense. So anyways, besides that, we also have Innard's special animation. So the secondary attack. So right there, Innard will play a little static noise, and will also have like a little bit of like a look animation, kind of like he's noticing somebody. It's like he sees somebody out of the corner of his eye. He's like, oh, what? Who's that? Who's over there? I guess I should go say hey to them. So it's kind of like an animation like that. But anyways, we also have Innard's run animation. So Innard doesn't really run. He just kind of like sprint jogs, which I mean, I guess it kind of makes sense because, you know, he's like a spaghetti wired animatronic. You know, there's like what, like 3 or 4 different animatronics inside of this guy. So they're all trying to work together to make this guy move around and stuff. So I'm assuming it'll probably be a little complex, but I guess that doesn't explain how Mr. Burn Trap is a rotten corpse inside of an animatronic and he's able to run a little bit faster than Innard. But Innard, he does have a run animation, so this is him running, and again, it's more like he's going for a little bit of a light jog, to say. So anyways, all that's left with Mr. Innard is all of the different sounds. So first of all, the space bar.
I don't understand.
So whenever you press the space bar, hey, be quiet. Whenever you press the space bar, it'll say one of Elizabeth's voice lines from the private room section whenever you fight Innard. While you're fighting Innard, Elizabeth will be talking from Innard, and you can press the space bar to play different Elizabeth sound effects. So whichever one, it is completely random. So you can just press this and listen to different sound effects.
Isn't this why you came here? Be with me.
I did come here to review you. What do you mean an accident? This ain't no accident.
Isn't this why you came here? Isn't this why you came with me? We need you. Be with me. Isn't this why you came?
The voices. They're back. The voices in my head. I just love that so much with these pill packs. Like, if you spam space, it just spams the audio. But anyways, we have the reload sound effect. So if we press reload, It'll play the ambience from the private room section. So there you go. So the reload sound effects are pretty much just background ambient sound effects, kind of based off of whatever character you are playing as. So this right here is Innard's background sound effect. And again, if you want to toggle it off, you just press reload once again, and that will stop the background audio. We have Innard's jump scare. So he'll do a nice little reach out with his arm and also open up his faceplates. One more thing though, I do have to say about Innard though, is I really like whenever you're walking around as him that some of his wires will jiggle around a bit. And also I love the detail of his different eyeballs blinking, like on his arms and on his torso. I love that they're blinking and stuff. So I think that is a beautiful little detail right there with this little guy. All right, so the next character we have is Nightmare Freddy. Oh, this guy is creepy looking. Just look at Nightmare Freddy. He's just got a wide stance. Like, yeah, he is about to throw a punch or something, man. Like, yo, I would not want to fight this guy right here. That's all I gotta say. So anyways, here is Nightmare Freddy. So we have his nice little ideal animation. We have his walk animation whenever he's walking around.
That child has to be here somewhere. I'm hungry. Also, I don't know what the Wi-Fi password is. Where is that child at? I thought we were having a sleepover. Also, where did all my Freddles go? Freddles! Freddles, I appear to have lost my children. Well, I guess now is a good time to go to the store to buy some milk.
So anyways, with Nightmare Freddy, we also have his little crouch animation. So if we crouch as Nightmare Freddy, oh, that is disturbing. So his eyes will roll into the back of his head and he will slouch over a little bit. Oh, this guy is so creepy. Again, the thing that's so creepy about the nightmares in FNAF 4 is that they breathe. Like, if you look at Nightmare Freddy right now, you can easily see that he is breathing. It's just, I don't know, it's just creepy. It's just so unsettling. I don't know how else to describe this. So here is Nightmare Freddy's crouch animation, and you can also walk around as Nightmare Freddy like this. So yeah, Nightmare Freddy is not happy.
What do you mean? What do you mean? My kids used my credit card. What do you mean they spent all my Freddy Fazbear coins? I spent so long getting all those tokens, and all my life savings are gone. Oh, what am I gonna do now?
It also looks like he's just kind of like old.
Oh, my back. Oh, I gotta shut down. My back is killing me. Oh.
So anyways, with Mr. Nightmare Freddy, we also have his special secondary animation. So there he does a little laugh animation right there, and he actually uses Nightmare Fredbear's laugh. So Nightmare Freddy will do a nice little laugh animation, kind of similar to a Burn Trap, how Burn Trap also has a laugh animation right there. And anyways, we also have Nightmare Freddy's run animation, and this guy is much faster than the other two. Oh my gosh, this guy is going to sprint towards you. Yo, look at this guy in the shadows. I do not like this. I don't like, hey yo. We got Nightmare Freddy's jump scare. Oh yeah, no, I do not want to mess with that guy. So boom, he'll stretch out his arms and open up his jaw. Do not mess with Nightmare Freddy. But anyways, we also have to check out the sounds that Nightmare Freddy can make. So first of all, we have the space bar. So the space bar will play the grandfather clock from Five Nights at Freddy's 4. We also have Nightmare Freddy's reload sound effect. So whenever you press the reload button, it'll play the ambience from the Five Nights at Freddy's Help Wanted main menu, which actually is reused in the FNAF 4 remastered version for mobile and consoles. So this is what the main music of FNAF 4 is used for, the menu and all the remastered versions, but not the original one for PC. But it is also the same one from Help Wanted. So there you go. There is Nightmare Freddy's ambient sound effect right there. And just like that, that's pretty much it to Mr. Nightmare Freddy. Again, I gotta say, just seeing Nightmare Freddy, he just looks so powerful and so strong. But obviously he is definitely the fastest pill pack so far in this pack. Yo, look at this guy. Look at him, man. He is so fast. All right, and the final animatronic we have to go over is the Mimic. So here is the Mimic, the final pill in Geo's junkyard currently. So the Mimic is here. So obviously the Mimic is from Five Nights at Freddy's Security Breach Ruin, and here is his ideal animation. So the Mimic is just vibing, he's chilling. I gotta say, I really do like how the cloth piece on his head does have an effect to it, like it's blown in the wind. I really do like that effect right there. But here's the Mimic. He's like, yo, what up guys, it's me, the Mimic. So here is the Mimic's normal walk animation right here, and as you can see, whenever the Mimic walks, he has one of his arms stretched out. That way, if you know somebody runs by him, he can easily grab them. So here is the Mimic. I gotta say, I absolutely love the Mimic. The Mimic is definitely one of my favorite Five Nights at Freddy's characters. But anyways, moving along, let's go ahead and check out the Mimic's crouch animation. So whenever the Mimic crouches, again, his arm is stretched out, but this time he's got a lot more movement. So now he's like moving his arm up and down, and he's breathing heavily. He's like, I'm so close yet so far away. And also, you cannot crouch walk as the Mimic, unfortunately, but again, whenever you do walk, he will also have his arm stretched out slightly. So whenever you do crouch, again, his arm is just stretched out. He's like, hi, how's it going, you guys? Want to give me a hand, come on, give me a hand. No, you're gonna leave me hanging. Oh dang, man, dang, oh dang. All right, so next that we have is the Mimic special animation, so let's check that out. There you go. So Mimic special animation, he does a little static thing, sort of similar to Innard, but except this time with the Mimic, again, he does reach his arm out. That's the Mimic's main thing right there, is him stretching out his left arm. So anyways, we have the Mimic's jump scare. There you go. So the Mimic will grab you and then give you a big old slap to the face. And finally for the Mimic, we have the different sounds. So we have the space bar, which is basically the alert sound effect from Security Breach Ruin. And we also have the Mimic's theme whenever you press reload. So the Mimic's theme will engage, and obviously this plays whenever the Mimic is chasing Cassie at the end of Ruin. So there you guys go. That is the final pill pack in Geo's Junkyard. Again though, I have to say, one of my favorite things about this pill pack is the head movement feature, where you are able to move your head all around the place based on where you are looking. Again, I just think that is a great detail to this pill pack. It just makes it feel so much more realistic. But there you guys go. There's all the four current characters in Geo's Junkyard. So again, like I said at the start of this video, this pill pack will probably get updated in the future, where more characters will be added. So if you guys do want me to check out this pill pack again whenever it does get updated, please let me know by leaving a like on this video. Also, let me know in the comments down below, out of these four characters from this pill pack, which one is your favorite and why? I gotta say, all these characters are fantastic in my opinion. I don't know which character I would say my favorite is. Personally, either Burn Trap or Nightmare Freddy. Both of these characters right here are really cool. Honestly, I think Nightmare Freddy barely takes the cake, mainly because of this crouch walk animation right here. This thing is just creepy right here. So personally, I think I'm gonna have to go with Nightmare Freddy, but Bird Trap is a super close second for me. And Innard and the Mimic, they are both still really good. But anyways, before we do end this video, even though that is it for the pill pack, we have some bonus add-ons to check out. Yep, that's right, bonus add-ons. So if we make our way over here, we got some extra ragdolls we are gonna check out in this video. So these guys are also made by Geo. So alongside the pill pack, if you guys do want to check out these ragdolls, they will be linked in the description below. And since there wasn't that many, I thought, hey, I would squeeze these guys in at the end of today's video. So first of all, we have a Spring Locks pack. So this pack contains Spring Bonnie, Withered Spring Bonnie, and Spring Trap. So this is a bit more of a stylized, realistic version of Spring Bonnie. And I have to say, especially out of all these characters right here, Spring Trap is the creepiest. Look at this guy. Ugh, he is disturbing. So we got regular Spring Bonnie, we have a withered version of him, and there is no human corpse inside of Withered Spring Bonnie. This is before Purple Guy throws on the Spring Bonnie suit and gets Spring Locked. So this is what Spring Bonnie is looking like. And then we have Spring Trap, where Purple Guy has actually been Spring Locked. And the cool thing about this Spring Trap model is that this guy actually has his feet casing, unlike the original Spring Trap from FNAF 3. And also, he is still having the top missing part of his ear, but it's just the metal endoskeleton instead of it being completely gone. And also, we have the entire human corpse inside of Mr. William Afton. So the cool thing with these ragdolls right here is they do have the nice, beautiful ear physics. And I gotta say, I love every single ragdoll that has ear physics. I'll always mention this whenever ragdoll has ear physics. I just absolutely love the ear physics on ragdolls. So all these guys do have some nice, beautiful ear physics, but these guys also do have some body groups. So with the body groups, you are actually able to remove the animatronic suit. So you can toggle the animatronic suit to reveal the beautiful Indo Bindo of the Spring Bonnie animatronic. So let's go ahead and take off the casing. You can also remove the eye casing and also toggle different effects on them. So if you want to like customize Spring Bonnie slightly, you easily can do so with the body groups on him. But this is what Spring Bonnie's endoskeleton looks like. This is the spring lock endoskeleton. Oh, this thing's kind of creepy, man. I'm starting to understand why they call it a spring lock, because looking at all the joints and stuff, they just look like giant springs for like the legs and the arms. It just looks like a giant spring. But you can see that there is actual spring locks in the center of the torso, all the little stabby mechanics right there, as I like to call them. So there is the endoskeleton of a regular Spring Bonnie. You can also do the same thing with a withered Spring Bonnie, and the same as well for Spring Trap. But we're gonna go ahead and take out Spring Trap suit because we need to see what Mr. William Afton looks like inside of the suit. Also, another thing to mention about the Spring Trap one is that he does come with a nice beautiful purple bow tie, and he does have both of his buttons instead of just the normal one. So let's go ahead and pop open the suit. Let's go ahead. Oh, he does also have some skins as well. So Spring Trap is the only character in this pack that does have some skins, but we will check those out in a second after we remove his suit. All right, come on, William Afton, don't be shy, take it off. It's okay, nobody's gonna judge you. Oh, there's Mr. William. Oh, okay, I just removed the corpse. So if you want to, you can toggle the corpse inside of the Spring Trap suit, but this is what it looks like with William Afton inside. Oh, this is just creepy, bro. He fits in perfectly, man. Oh, ew, look at his neck. His neck is snapped just based off the way he's turned. But yeah, this is William Afton inside of the Spring Lock suit. Oh, this guy is creepy. Oh, look at this. Oh, it's so... put the clothes back on! All right, we're gonna go ahead and spawn in a brand new Spring Trap right here. So let's go ahead and let's see what those skins are all about for Mr. Spring Trap. So if we go ahead and switch it to skin one, his eyes become white, and skin two, his eyes become more purplish. And it looks like skin zero is kind of a mix in between. So you have like pretty much purple eyes, you have white eyes, and then you have a mix of like purplish, whitish eyes right there. So that is a nice effect. And also, I am pretty sure that his eyes will glow up in the dark. Yep, they do. That is, that's not creepy at all.
Hey there, don't you want to follow me to the back room? Come on, follow me.
Yeah, that's not creepy at all. Well, I'm not going to be following him because I want to check out Mr. Spring Bonnie. So we got one more Spring Bonnie Ragdoll to check out. And this guy is not a part of the Spring Locks pack. This guy is in his own beautiful add-on right here. So here is a version of Spring Bonnie. Again, a realistic version of Spring Bonnie. And honestly, when I look at this guy, it kind of reminds me of like a more of a realistic style of Spring Bonnie. And he's kind of similar to the Spring Bonnie we see in the FNAF movie. Definitely the repaired version of Spring Bonnie, but obviously he does have some major differences. One of the differences that I just now noticed is that his hands are actually plastic while the rest of his body is more of a furish material. So that is a nice detail right there, because obviously you would have your hands inside. Hey, yo, don't remind me, bro. Dang, the Gmod FNAF bundle pack doesn't have to expose me like that. I'm sorry I didn't get your backgrounds. I just really like the default Gmod backgrounds. Anyways, as I was saying, so with the Spring Bonnie hands, he does have a plastic material. And also, if you look closely, you can see that he does have a few scratches on him since the suit has been worn for a while. And also it makes sense because he does look slightly dirty, especially if you look at his face and also at his muzzle. And also his eyes do have some like little veins in them. So that's not creepy whatsoever. Oh, this is just an unsettling version of Spring Bonnie. I feel like you would see this Spring Bonnie in like a VHS tape. Like this guy is actually pretty creepy. Also with Spring Bonnie right here, his feet do have black pads on the bottom of them, just in case you are curious. And no, they are not a part of his endoskeleton foot clipping through the actual suit. It's actually just padding for the bottom of his feet, which makes sense because you wouldn't really see the bottoms of his feet since he will be standing on stage all day. And there you go. So anyways, with Mr. Spring Bonnie, again, just like the other guys, you can toggle his suit. So let's go ahead and toggle his suit. You can also toggle the endoskeleton parts on this Spring Bonnie Ragdoll, but let's go ahead and remove the Spring Bonnie suit. There we go. Spring Bonnie's endoskeleton right here. Yep, that's not creepy. Oh, look at that Indo Bindo mouth right there. Look at that head. Oh, that's creepy. That endoskeleton head right there just reminds me straight of the FNAF 4 Nightmare endoskeleton head. Oh, that's disturbing. Giving me the eevee heebie-jeebies. Anyways, you can also go ahead and toggle all of the different endoskeleton parts. So if you wanted to go ahead and actually have it inverted to just have an empty spring Bonnie suit, you could do that as well. So if we go ahead and toggle the entire endoskeleton and reapply everything else, we can actually have ourselves a empty spring Bonnie suit. Oh yeah, that's not creepy whatsoever. All right, go ahead, toggle the pelvis, toggle the arms. Oh, wait, no, that's the endo arm. So there you go, we got Mr. Spring Bonnie. And you can also toggle the eyes, which I believe that they're actually glowable. I think that's what the toggleable thing is, because his eyes do come back whenever you apply the head. So, wait, what? Okay, there we go. We get rid of the eyes and we add the head. So yeah, see, there is eyes that come with the head. So I'm pretty sure they do glow in the dark. So if we take him over here in the darkness right now, his eyes are toggleable. So what is the difference with his eyeballs? What is the difference? I'm confused. I think that might be a bug. I'm pretty sure the eyes are supposed to get rid of the eyes in his head, but he has like two sets of eyes because there's a set of eyes attached to his head. So I don't know. That's trippy. There might be a difference between them, but I kind of doubt it. So there's the spring Bonnie suit, bro. Bro skipped leg day, bro. Bro straight up skipped leg day. Also, one more thing I do want to go ahead and check out really quickly because I kind of forgot while I was messing around with Springtrap is I wanted to see what this guy looks like without the corpse inside of his suit. So let's go ahead and remove the corpse. And there we go. This is a empty Springtrap suit. So this version of Springtrap doesn't have William Afton inside. So again, this guy's super creepy. But anyways, that is going to be it for today's review video. So thank you guys so much for watching. Again, feel free to check out all the add-ons I showed off in today's video. And again, all of them are made by Geo. So thank you guys so much for watching today's video. And thank you to Geo for making all these incredible add-ons. They were all beautiful. But that's it for today. Make sure to leave a like if you guys do want to see more review videos. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye! Yippee!